Okay, I'm going to solve the next question, which is also related to the electronics. Question number 21. I hope you all understand. We have given one question which is related with PN junction. Yes, PN junction is also a special kind of PN junction here, step graded PN junction diode. And we have given one hint or one numerical data to solve this question, is that if the ratio of acceptor to donor impurity atom density is 1:2, if the ratio of acceptor to donor impurity of atom is 1:2, then what is the ratio of deflection region penetration depth into the PN N region? This P region and this N region, and the middle of this PN junction is known as PN junction. These two from here P junction and from here N junction, and this made by PN junction. And in this PN junction, we have given acceptor to donor impurity ratio. Acceptor is above and donor is below. 1:2. We have given 1:2. Now, what is the ratio of deflection region? Means the P junction donor region is twice of than that of acceptor if the 1:2. Means suppose acceptor is A1, donor is D1 is equal to the ratio of P types. Means ratio of P types means PD upon ND. This is our P types and N type deflection region. This final answer is 2:1. Now question number 21 number question. We have given 21 number question. Consider a germanium diode operating at 27 degrees Celsius. Consider a germanium diode operating at 27 degrees Celsius and just beyond the threshold, just beyond the threshold voltage of germanium, what is the value of dV over dt? We have given one germanium diode operating at 27 degrees Celsius and just beyond the threshold voltage. Consider a germanium diode. This GE means germanium diode. and just beyond the threshold voltage of germanium, what is the value of dV by dt? Option A. Option A, minus 19.1 millivolt per degree Celsius. Option B, minus 2.0 millivolt per degree Celsius. Option C, minus 2.1 millivolt per degree Celsius. Option D, minus 2.3 millivolt per degree Celsius. Consider a germanium diode operating at 27 degree Celsius. मानों कि उड़ा germanium diode छ, this diode is operating at 27 degree Celsius. Means this germanium diode is perform their task or their function at 27 degree Celsius. And just beyond the threshold voltage of the germanium, what is the value of dV by dt? Here the term threshold voltage means the zero voltage or the initial voltage. It is one kind of threshold voltage, means it is one kind of voltage, it is standard voltage, it is one kind of standard voltage. Beyond this voltage, means beyond this threshold voltage of germanium, what is the value of dV and dt? We mention here dV and dt in the form of millivolt per degree Celsius. This is also known as temperature gradient. I think this T is not denoted by temperature, and this V is voltage. Voltage is changed by with the changing temperature. So we have given these four options. Then we should know which is the best answer. So I think this answer is option number, question number 21, D, 2.3 mega electron volt per degree Celsius. Why this is our correct answer? We have given one formula for calculating these types of voltage gradient by one formula that I forget this formula right now. Just now I'm going to brief you this question in this class today. I forget exactly where it is. We have given one formula. PN junction diode, yes, germanium diode reverse junction saturation line 2.024 2 million voltage, and exactly I forget 00 diode. How it obtained? We have no the standard germanium. It's option D, okay. And I'm going to solve the next question. Question number 22. Evalence multiplication. The disruption of covalent bond occur by silicon. I have given this question. Really, I don't know about this question, okay. No any concept about this question, how to solve it exactly. But I know this germanium diode has a value, two different value at a different situation. Its exactly value is 1.8 millivolt per degree Celsius as below the threshold value. And similarly, it has a upper standard value. This is nearly about nearly about -1.8, and the next one is 2.022 millivolt per degree Celsius. If we add these two values, then what we get? No idea exactly. I have no any idea how to solve this one. Okay, try yourself and solve this one. Search from Google's and try to solve this one. Yes, question number 22. Again, okay? I'm going to solve the question number 22. Avalanche multiplication, and we have given one option A. Disruption of covalent bond occurred by collision. Disruption of covalent bond occurs by collision. Option B. We have given direct rupture bond. Option C. Both A and B. Option D. None of these. Yes. Avalanche multiplication. Yes, avalanche multiplication disruption of covalent bond occurred by collision. Avalanche multiplication. How do avalanche increase or how do avalanche decrease? Avalanche means we know. Avalanche occur when P types of semiconductor and N types of semiconductor are bonded and there is formation of deflection layer, and this deflection layer is very wide when the energy band between these P types and N types is too huge or too fast. If the similar types of P types and N types, similar electron or similar energy band containing electron element or p-types or n-types semiconductor are bonded or fixed off, then there is a very thin p-n junction, and this p-n junction may be breakdown with multiplication during which condition we know this condition among these four option. We know one of the option tells us during which situation avalanche multiplication. Okay, so question number 22, option number A, disruption of covalent bond occurred by collision. When covalent bond are disruption means when silicon and germanium or phosphate is combined, then there is formation of types of bone which is known as covalent bone. Okay, this disruption means rupture. There is no any rupture or there is no any break down between this barrier which is formed between PN and N types of junction, okay, avalanche multiplication, disruption of covalent bond occur by collision. This is our second question answer option. Yes, similarly we have given this question number 23 question. Avalanche breakdown is primarily depend upon the phenomena of which phenomena avalanche multiplication is depend which I'm going to solve the next question. Okay, this is our option number A. Avalanche multiplication is occur when disruption of the covalent bond occur by collision. Okay, and similar next question. Yes. Avalanche breakdown is primarily depend on the phenomena of avalanche. Question number 23. Avalanche breakdown. Avalanche breakdown is primarily depend on the phenomena of primarily depend on the phenomena of first collision. Number second, doping. Number C, ionization. Number D, recombination. Yes, we have given one question which related to avalanche breakdown. Yeah, I'm already explained about the phenomena of this avalanche, when the avalanche occur, if the p types of semiconductor and n types of semiconductor are bind, then there is formation of one types of junction, this p np junction, and this np junction is breakdown. It may be breakdown when the p types and n types of semiconductor of doping layer, sorry, means the electrons mobility or electrons density, the rate of penetration of electron density and the mobility of electron density is high, then it may be deflected, which it means here, the it means the p-n junction died, which is the situation at the between of the n and p types of semiconductor. And this avalanche breakdown is primarily depend on the phenomena of collision, doping, ionization, recombination. Which phenomena it depend? Question number 23 answer is that A is avalanche breakdown is mainly occur, primarily means occur or it depend on the phenomena of collision of electron. Okay, when the electron are bombardment or struck on the p sides of the junction from the p region, and similarly the electrons are struck or penetrate or hit on the n types, and there is formation of one p p-n junction barrier, which is p-n junction barrier is formed by p-types and n-types of semiconductor, and during bombardment of electron on this barrier, which phenomena? During collision of charge carrier, it may be electron, it may be hole, and this collision of electron on this barrier may cause the avalanche breakdown, okay. The next question, question number 24. Question number 24. Yes, silicon is preferred for manufacture gene or diode because, yes, we have given one of the sample of the atom or the element silicon, which is silicon is preferred means acceptable. It may be highly used by the scientist or by electrician to made or manufacture of Zener diode for manufacture of Zener diode because of number option A, it relatively cheap, needs lower doping level, and has high temperature and current capacity. Silicon has a high temperature. High temperature and current capacity. And at last, option D has a low breakdown voltage. Yeah, we already know, I think all of the know about this silicon atom. Its atomic number is 14 and its electronic configuration is 284. And I know this silicon atom is tetravalent element, which contain 4 electrons in their outermost orbit. Okay, so due to this 4 electrons in their outermost orbit, into the outermost orbit, it can easily form the covalent bond with the other element when combined to each other. Okay, so I think silicon is preferred by manufacture of Zener diode. Means silicon mainly used to manufacture a Zener diode. Why? The reason is that we have given the four option. It is relatively cheap. Means it is available everywhere and it is very costly. It is very 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 cheap. Means it has a very low cost rate. Our next question is, need lower doping level. Means silicon need lower doping level because it is tetravalent element, and this is the option it has a very low, it needs very low doping level. Similarly, it has a high temperature and current capacity. Silicon has a one specific characteristics is that high temperature, it has a high temperature and a current capacity. Similarly, it has a low breakdown voltage. Among the four options, which is the best option, on the basis of this best option or on the basis of this best characteristics, scientists or technicians may highly prefer of manufacture of zener diode by using of silicon. Question number 24. See, yeah, it has a high temperature and current capacity. Option number C. And today, the last question of this class is question number 24. Question 24. For a rectifier circuit, percentage voltage voltage regulation is equal to which of the point? For a rectifier circuit, percentage voltage regulation is equal to which of the following? Yeah, we have given one rectifier circuit. Yes, and this rectifier circuit, for a rectifier circuit, percentage voltage regulation is equal to which of the following? We have given four options. Okay. Option A, B no loaded. Option B, V no loaded upon full loaded, V full load multiply 100. Okay, and similarly option C, V no loaded up minus V full loaded upon V no loaded no load plus V full load multiply 100, and at last option D, B full loaded upon B loaded. For rectifier circuit, percentage voltage regulation is equal to which of the following? B no loaded, B no loaded minus B full loaded upon B full loaded into 100%, 5%. Okay, only this much for today. We also meet again. Coming during in next video. Okay, thank you, bye.